Hey everyone, DDR5 prices have thankfully come down loads in recent years, meaning that more people than ever are considering an upgrade to a DDR5 based system. However, some people say that DDR5 RAM runs too hot and can overheat. But is this true, and why have some people removed the factory heatsink and then stuck random bits of metal on the PCB instead? Well, let's take each question in turn. Yes, DDR5 RAM does run fairly hot. It's a bit like how Gen 5 NVMe drives are hotter than Gen 4 ones, and so you really need to pay attention to how you're cooling your Gen 5 SSDs. Some people have found that the DDR5 RAM runs at 70 to 80 degrees Celsius, especially when experimenting with mild overclocks. That's pretty high. Now, Crucial does say that their DDR5 sticks work up to 95 degrees Celsius, but in reality you'll experience thermal throttling and possibly memory errors if your RAM gets up that high. That's kinda why some people then perform funky mods to their RAM. In an ideal world, you should probably aim for your DDR5 RAM to run below 60 to 70 degrees Celsius during typical use. So does this mean that if you purchase DDR5 RAM, you're gonna have loads of thermal problems? Well, probably not. Apart from some early teething issues a couple of years ago, DDR5 is fairly stable now. And so if you purchase brand new RAM from a reputable company like Gscale, Corsair, or Kingston, it's unlikely that you'll experience thermal issues. That's because RAM makers nowadays usually use the appropriate cooling solution for the RAM. The faster the RAM, the hotter it will run. In other words, if the DDR5 you purchase runs at a slow speed, say between 4800 and 5400 MHz, the RAM sticks will likely be naked. They won't have any heatsink or heat spreader on them. And that's because these lower and high latency sticks don't usually generate too much heat. But a low CL RAM that runs at 6000 MHz, for example, will run hotter. That's why you'll pretty much always see them with an aluminum sheath on them, to use the American term. But of course, that's not a sheath, it's a heatsink. It helps to move heat away from the DDR5 RAM so that it doesn't overheat. You can check your RAM temps fairly easily. A free program like HWinfo will show your RAM temperature, as will some packaged software like the ASUS Armoury Crate. You should check your DDR5 temps when idle, and also when using your computer, whether that's for gaming, video editing, or doing AI work. You can also kick things up a notch and use a program like MemTest86 or TestMem5 to really stress test your RAM and check the temperatures then. Ideally, your RAM will still be below 70 degrees Celsius during these tests. I should quickly point out though that not all RAM modules actually have temperature sensors within them. If HWinfo doesn't show any RAM temperature reading, that's probably why. In this case, you can either hope for the best, or take the don't try this at home approach and touch the RAM module inside your computer with the back of your hand. Be careful though, if the RAM is running at 80 degrees Celsius, you could burn. But if you're careful and you slowly move the back of your hand towards the RAM, you should be okay. This isn't medical advice though. If in doubt, just don't touch it. Anywho, let's say that you are concerned by your DDR5 temps. Do you need a special cooling solution? Well, maybe. The default heat sinks on DDR5 RAM will always be inherently limited because RAM modules are spaced fairly close together in the motherboard. And if the heat sinks were really wide, you just wouldn't be able to fit all of your RAM into the motherboard slots. So if you have above average demands for your RAM, for example, you're overclocking it or you have a small form factor build, you might need to explore alternative cooling methods, even if physically modifying your RAM will almost certainly void the warranty, and that's worth knowing. What some people have done is use a specialist heatsink or apply some aluminium heatsink fins like these. The greater surface area of these will help to better move heat away from the RAM. So to firstly remove the original heatsink, you'll need to use a heat gun or hairdryer to gently heat the adhesive, and then you should be able to pry it off. Once this is done, you're left with the naked or bare RAM stick. You can then either apply the specialist heatsink by following the instructions, or you can use special heatsink adhesive to glue aluminium fins onto the back of the memory chips. At this point, your RAM should run cooler than the default heatsink, but most people take things a step further and mount a series of fans above them. 40mm or 1.5-inch fans like the Noctua A410s can work especially well for this. A few people have followed this approach, and their DDR5 temps end up below 40 degrees Celsius, which is pretty impressive. But of course, case airflow is generally important here too. You want to make sure that the colder intake air is flowing near your RAM for best results. And that wraps up this video. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please click the thumbs up button because this tells the YouTube algorithm that more people should see this video. Please also subscribe to this channel if you aren't already, and thanks for watching.